Hello and welcome. Today we're focusing on another exciting development from Canon Medical for liver disease assessment, attenuation imaging. My name is Todd Erpelding and I'm a Senior Clinical Collaborations Manager with Canon Medical Systems USA. Attenuation imaging is a new and unique ultrasound technology from Canon Medical on the Aplio I series. It can provide additional quantitative information to aid in the assessment of liver steatosis, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, which are all characterized by elevated levels of fat accumulation in the liver. It does this by providing a real-time display and quantification of the ultrasound attenuation coefficient, which increases as the amount of fat in the liver increases. Hepatic steatosis on ultrasound appears as a diffuse increase in echogenicity, or bright liver, caused by the intracellular accumulation of fat vacuoles. The resulting ultrasound signal attenuation is elevated in fatty livers due to increased scattering and absorption of the ultrasound wave as it propagates through tissue. Current ultrasound methods to assess steatosis include visual assessments of echogenicity and measurements of the ratio of echo amplitudes between the liver and kidney. However, these techniques are subjective, operator dependent, and generally lack the sensitivity required to assess mild steatosis. Attenuation imaging is a quantitative method for the assessment of steatosis, uniquely available in the Canon I-Series ultrasound systems. This is easily accessed from the same acoustic window as used for shear wave elastography, allowing for seamless workflow, and can be launched via the touchscreen. Here we see the imaging region of interest, or ROI, which enables an immediate visual assessment of liver attenuation. In this case, orange indicates regions with higher attenuation, and blue indicates lower attenuation regions. The real-time attenuation color map can be displayed side by side with the corresponding grayscale image. Large vessels and echogenic structures are automatically excluded from the imaging ROI, making it easy to assess attenuation from the liver parenchyma. Once the image is frozen, the measurement ROI automatically appears and can be pre-sized for fast operation. After ROI placement, a single button press completes the acquisition. The mean intensity curve is the average intensity along the depth direction within the measurement ROI and is used to calculate the attenuation coefficient displayed at the bottom in units of dB per centimeter megahertz. The quality of your acquisition is important to provide diagnostic confidence. Quality can be confirmed via the coefficient of determination, or R-squared value. An R-squared value of greater than 0.9, as seen here, indicates an excellent fit to the expected model. Measurement ROI placement can be guided to regions of high quality by observing the font color of the attenuation coefficient. A red font color indicates an area where measurements should be avoided. A yellow font color indicates an area where measurements may be unreliable. Reliable measurements can be made when the attenuation coefficient is displayed in white, indicating an R-squared value of greater than 0.9. Here are examples of how attenuation coefficient increases with liver fat content in cases of mild, moderate, and severe steatosis. Let's look at a few cases. This is a man in his early 20s diagnosed with non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, or NASH, and ulcerative colitis, showing fatty liver on qualitative ultrasound. Histopathological examination following liver biopsy demonstrate F2 stage fibrosis and A2 grade inflammation, indicating significant fibrosis and moderate inflammatory activity. Fat content was scored at 90%, indicating severe steatosis. Quantitative ultrasound assessment using attenuation imaging and shear wave elastography show consistent findings. This patient is at risk for further disease progression due to the effects of inflammation and fibrosis. As this example shows, attenuation imaging and shear wave elastography can provide complementary quantitative information to help increase diagnostic confidence. When NASH progresses to liver cirrhosis, the extent of steatosis will decrease, as shown in this example from a 60-year-old female with burned-out NASH. Histopathological examination following liver biopsy demonstrate F4 cirrhosis, A2 grade inflammation, and 8% fat content. In order to fully investigate burned-out NASH, both liver stiffness and steatosis need to be examined. A more comprehensive liver disease assessment can be performed using the quantitative results from both shear wave elastography and attenuation imaging. In conclusion, the prevalence of fatty liver disease is on the rise, and its assessment is a continuing challenge. Attenuation imaging is a quick and easy quantitative method to aid in steatosis assessment, and is another way that the AppBlue iSeries from Canon Medical is expanding the use of ultrasound. For more information, visit our website or follow us on YouTube and Twitter. Thank you.